Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel for another video. If you're new and this is the first video of mine you're watching, welcome. My name is Ashley. I'm a homeschooling mom of four and I've been sharing my homeschooling journey and little bits and pieces of my life here on my YouTube channel for the last 5 years. Today's video is a special one and it is brought to you in partnership with The Good and the Beautiful. I am really excited to be sharing today's video with you guys because I feel like I am linking arms with a bunch of other warriors in the quest at providing good books for our kids. Now, if you are not a homeschooling parent, this video is actually for you. Most of the content that I create on my channel is directed towards homeschooling parents. However, this is a video for any parent, a homeschooling parent, a public school parent, a charter school parent, a private school parent. This is a video for any parent. I am going to be talking with you guys today about the importance of our kids reading good books. What does that even look like? What does that even mean? And then sharing with you a really amazing, generous, just so incredibly generous program that The Good and the Beautiful is offering for the summertime. And this is something that I would love if you guys shared this video. I never ask for my videos to be shared, but I would love if you guys helped get this message out there because I truly believe that a lot of parents out there, especially these days, need to hear this message. So this is gonna be like a little bit of a heartfelt video at the beginning, and then I will jump into explaining the program that The Good and the Beautiful is offering. And I would really, really love it if you guys showed your support by leaving me a thumbs up, a comment, letting me know your thoughts on this topic or this issue, and then in addition to that, sharing. But if you are a parent, this video is for you. This is not just for homeschoolers, so I want to make that super duper clear. So before I took my kids out of public school, I was a parent with the mindset personally that, you know, I would say, I would probably have said the phrase myself, you know, I don't really care what they're reading as long as they're reading. That's kind of a widely accepted statement among all parents. We all want our kids to be reading. We know the benefits for them to be strong readers, avid readers, but there is a bit of a disconnect when it comes to filtering what our kids read. Now, it's no secret that over the past few years, especially the type of literature and the quality of books that our kids have been consuming has gone far downhill. There's alarming statistics that show this, that almost every single book in the 1950s to the 1960s contained high moral quality, important lessons, character development in every book that our kids were reading. Since then, it has been a steady decline, and books are just not what they used to be. So this is a mission that Jenny Phillips, the creator of The Good and the Beautiful homeschooling curriculum, which if you're not a homeschooling parent, you might not know, but a quick brief overview of The Good and the Beautiful is that Jenny herself is a homeschooling mom and she never intended on creating a curriculum company, but the company has turned into a huge curriculum company and it has blessed the lives of millions of children worldwide. And her greatest passion for creating her company and curriculum is making sure that our kids are getting quality education, and books go hand in hand with that. Jenny shares very candidly about her own child's story of how she noticed that her daughter was acting in a way that wasn't typical and wasn't, you know, allowable in their home. And she was able to identify that a lot of the books that her daughter was reading at that time were influencing her and affecting her behavior. So they had a radical change in their home. And that is really what birthed the passion of Jenny Phillips, the creator of The Good and the Beautiful, to make sure that our kids are reading good books. it wasn't until I started homeschooling that I became aware that I had failed in certain areas while my kids were in public school with books that I was allowing them to read. I was a busy mom of four, and my kids were all very young at the time, and I just did not have the time or really the awareness that I needed to be proofreading every book that my child was checking out from the school library or reading in their classrooms. I trusted at that point that the books my kids were reading at school were probably screened by educators and that they were probably safe, but that really couldn't be more far from the truth. And that is what I am here to share with you guys today. If you are a parent whose children attend a public, private charter school, wherever you send your children for their education, you have to be aware of what your kids are reading. Gone are the days where the books that line school library shelves and public library shelves are filled with goodness and great things that we want our kids to be consuming. Just in the recent months, there have been alarming detailed reportings in the state of Texas where it was in a high school age range where the books were borderline pornographic, not even borderline, they were pornographic. And these were books that high schoolers who were taking an AP, so that would be an advanced class, were reading. And it was graphic and disturbing. And the parents had no idea. When confronted with it, the school district actually said that due to everything that had gone on in the current climate, that they were just unaware and books weren't properly screened. But that is just one isolated incident. That's just one that's been more recently that I've been made aware of. But this has gone on for quite a while now. There are tons and tons and tons of inappropriate books that your kids can be reading at school. Things that conflict with, you know, their faith or your family's faith. Things that conflict with things that you've taught them about family. Things that are just downright disturbing, which is what I was mentioning about the school district in Texas. So you cannot just rely on the fact that, you know, the school is providing this book and so it's probably safe to read, because that is not always the case, unfortunately. So this video is really just to bring awareness to the issue, because just like movies, music, and friends influence our children, books do as well. You know, it's a little bit different, I think, because when we're watching a movie together as a family, if we see something that we don't agree with, we're all right there and we can discuss it, we can talk about it, we can turn it off, we can make sure, you know, that what is going into my child's mind is something that I feel okay about as a parent. But when your children are reading, unless they're reading out loud to you all of the time, which as they get older, they do less and less, you might never know what your kids are reading and what they might be reading that they don't understand, or what they might be reading that is disturbing, or, you know, it can just be so many things. So I think it's very, 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 very important that every parent is aware, and that it's okay for you as a parent, if your child comes home with a book to do a book report on or a book club after school, to, you know, tell their teacher, we're not going to read that book. Do you have an alternative? And, you know, it was only because of parents that stood up for saying this content is disgusting, this is disturbing, this is wrong on so many levels, that school district in Texas that I was just talking with you about was even made aware of what these books contained. And only because of parents was it able to be to have those books to be removed from the shelves. Now, they haven't permanently been removed. They're under review right now. And so it is so important to remember that your children are your children. Just because they attend school elsewhere doesn't mean that you do not have the right or the permission to verify what your kids are consuming. And it has never been more important to do so. So I am linking arms with Jenny Phillips, the creator of The Good and the Beautiful, as well as everybody at The Good and the Beautiful, to spread this message about good books. Our children need to be consuming good books. They need to be consuming things that are building up their character. They need to be consuming things that show families with kind interactions and love and Christ-like behavior. This is what our kids need to be consuming, not things working in opposition of that when there's already so much opposition in the world as it stands. So I no longer take the approach of, I'm just glad they're reading, I don't care what it is. I definitely filter what my kids read. And you'll notice that I am not sitting here saying, your kids should not read this book or that book or this book or that book, because I don't think that that's the right approach to this. What I'm saying is, be aware, make sure you know what your kids are reading, because there can be hidden messages in the middle of the book that if you just gloss through the first few or the last few pages, you might find something that you are not in agreement with and you don't want your child reading. So every family is to determine their own moral standards for what is appropriate in their homes, but this is really just a call for parents to be aware that all books are not created equal, and to be aware that what your child is reading does affect them in the same way that if they watch repeated R-rated movies would, with profanity and adult message. The same thing as if they listen to provocative, demeaning music, they're going to start taking on those types of words. It's just proof that what we take in is what we produce. And so literature is no different than that. And now I know you might be thinking, well, there's just no way that I can read every single book that my kid wants to read. It's just impossible. Well, that is where The Good and the Beautiful has truly, truly blessed my life as a busy mom of four, because they have an entire library available on the website that and book lists of books where they have put it through the ringer of standards according to The Good and the Beautiful and provided us with a list of books or a library where we know what we're buying is safe for our children to read, and we do not have to read the entire book cover to cover to make sure of it. So there are a lot of resources out there. The Good and the Beautiful is just one of them that is truly passionate about this, and that is why I wanted to share it with you guys. Also, I would like to mention that on The Good and the Beautiful's YouTube channel, you can go and watch Jenny's whole story about her daughter. It is very, 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 very inspiring and impactful, and I have seen it within my children in my own home. As I said, when my kids were in public school, I definitely had a different approach than I do once I was made aware of it. And I was only made aware of the significance of the importance of what my kids were reading. Of course, there were things that I didn't allow as far as like horror books and things like that, but I wasn't as involved, and I have The Good and the Beautiful to thank for making me aware of that. And since that time, we have combed through our shelves quite a bit and gotten rid of a lot of books that just were not good books. And it's not necessarily just the message that it's conveying, but there's a lot of other things that go into it that make a book worth reading. Jenny has a lot of that information on The Good and the Beautiful's YouTube channel as well as the website. And that passion of hers is what has led to this incredible, incredible, incredible program they are offering this summer. This is why I want you to share this with your friends who do not homeschool, because you might be able to get a book in the hands of a child that will open their eyes to reading good, wholesome, quality literature. So The Good and the Beautiful is doing a summer reading challenge program. I have to tell you guys, the incredible generosity of The Good and the Beautiful never ceases to amaze me just with the pricing that they offer on their curriculum. However, Jenny really wanted this to be entirely free. All you do is pay $1 for shipping, and your child or the child that you might be thinking of that could really use, a good book in their hands can receive this book. There's three different levels, which I'll talk about in a second, wrapped just like this with such a cute little note on the front that is going to potentially open their eyes, open their hearts to reading a really good book. This is the Good and the Beautiful's summer reading program. Now, inside the wrapping is the book, and there are three different books that are available for this. There's a book for lower elementary, there's a book for upper elementary, middle school, and then there's another book more upper, middle, and high school. So there's three different levels. Along with each one that will be wrapped up just like this comes the beautiful little woodland scene here, where they have this card on here. It says, you know, their reading challenge is to set a goal and record the books that they read, track your progress with the stickers, and celebrate when you meet your goal. So there's bookmarks in here from The Good and the Beautiful, and then of course this super cute little woodland scene to really just inspire kids to be reading over the summer. So every book they complete, they add a sticker into here and they can keep track right here. I want to read you the letter on the front of it, because I feel like everyone needs to hear this. So it says, hello, thank you for joining the Good and the Beautiful Summer Reading Program. Did you know that every book you read affects you? Some books show it is funny and acceptable to lie or make fun of parents, siblings, and teachers, while other books inspire us to have respect and gratitude. Some books use potty language and disrespect as entertainment. Other books are entertaining without using any bad language or disrespect. The Bible teaches us to seek things that are true, honest, pure, virtuous, and lovely. This applies to all things, even books. I encourage you to always have those words be your guide when choosing what books you will read. Ask yourself, is this book pure? Is it virtuous? Is it lovely? This may require you to avoid a lot of today's popular books, but you can do it. I promise you that it will make you more confident and a happier person who will be a bright light in the world. What you read really does make a difference in who you become in this life, and I can't wait for you to participate in the activities and reading in the Good and the Beautiful Summer Reading Program, and for you to receive your reward after you complete the program. Sincerely, Jenny Phillips, the founder of the Good and the Beautiful. That gives me literal tears in my eyes, because it is so true, you guys. There is a war against our children, and the enemy wants our children to not be fixing their minds on what is pure and what is lovely and what is virtuous. So I invite you guys to join me and the Good and the Beautiful on this mission of making sure that kids are reading good books always, but especially over the summertime. And maybe it's just going to take receiving a book for a dollar in the mail for a parent's mind to be opened and a child's heart to be changed forever. So I would invite you guys to share this video with your friends, share it with other homeschoolers, and get your kids involved in the summer reading challenge at The Good and the Beautiful. I will have their website linked down below, and I can show you guys again the sweet packaging. And did I mention that this is free? So just think about the heart behind that. It is truly, truly inspiring and incredible. And I just don't have adequate words, because Jenny is so successful, and that was never her intention. Her intention really is to just help homeschooling moms and help kids read good books. And so thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it encouraged you. I hope it inspired you. Head to The Good and the Beautiful to check out the summer reading program. Like I said, they have three different books that they are offering for a variety of ages, and maybe you can get one and pass it along to a child in your life who wouldn't ordinarily hear this important message. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions, and I will see you all in my next video really soon. Bye, guys. Smile.